So today I want to share with you five different reasons why you should love dividend investing. Hey everyone, Dennis here on the True Financials channel, where we love to talk about ways to make money, save money, and invest money for your financial future. So today I'm excited to share with you these five different reasons for dividend investing. Now, I personally have been investing in dividends for quite some time. I actually share my journey right here on this YouTube channel with my portfolio, what I'm invested in, and then how much I actually make in dividends every single month. Now, if you want to see those investing videos, make sure you are following along by hitting that subscribe button down below. Now, when it comes to making this video talking about the reasons why I love dividend investing, I actually partnered up with my friend Jared Morrow, who actually is a little bit against dividend investing, not entirely, but has some reasons why you shouldn't actually be investing with dividends, and he's gonna share his tips here at the end of the video, so make sure you guys stick around for that, because it's always great to have some contrast on, you know, the pros and cons of every decision you make when it comes to investing, and I think he has some really good tips that can really benefit you guys in making the decision on if you should go with dividend investing or if you should go with other opportunities for investing. All right, so the first reason to love dividend investing is, of course, for the passive income that it creates. Now, I know passive income can kind of be a really tossed out word there, especially in today's age with YouTube and people making videos about passive income, but it really truly is in some form a passive way to make income. Because if you invest in companies and they are paying you money every single quarter or however often that they pay, that is money that you've earned for pretty much doing almost nothing. Granted, there's some research on the side that you have to do beforehand or that you should at least be doing beforehand, but overall, you're making this money by just having your money sitting in an account and having ownership into these different companies. So this is a really awesome feature for a lot of people, because if you can have money generating for you every single quarter without having to do a lot of work, honestly, that is one of my favorite things when it comes to it. Not that I'm lazy, not that I don't want to work, but I also like having money working for me that I don't have to put a lot of time and effort into once I've set everything in motion. And of course, this also means that when you are creating passive income, depending on when you actually do it, it can be a really significant amount if you are focusing it over time, how much you have in your account. Now, one of the big downsides when it comes to creating passive income with dividend investing is that it typically needs a lot more capital to be able to generate a good significant amount of passive income. Obviously, if you are doing this over time, it won't be a big deal, but if you are looking to generate that 3-4% income and needing like thousands of dollars every single month, you're gonna have to be putting in quite a bit of money to help generate that money coming in. So for most people, it's beneficial if you're getting started early to help you build up your portfolio so your dividend income is just getting reinvested, which we'll be talking about here in a second, as well as being able to one day in the future have money coming in enough to the point where it can pay your bills and take care of your financial needs. So the next reason to love dividend investing is because typically it is a little bit less risk than other stocks. Now, this might sound weird because, of course, any type of investment that you're doing is always going to be a risk. But risk management is a huge factor when it comes to a lot of people and how they're able to actually put their money into the stock market. Because if you are putting your money into a lot of growth stock, that is going to have a higher potential for risk, which means there's going to be a lot more ups and downs, which can be a good and bad thing, of course. But when it comes to dividend stocks, at least if you're doing your right research, you're typically going to be putting your money into what they call blue chip stocks, which are essentially those bigger companies like Walmart, McDonald's, Target, companies that have been around for a long time and have been producing a really good yield when it comes to their dividend. Now, this less risk is because these companies are already big and massive. And so what they do is they want to mitigate a lot of their own risk. So they pay back a higher yield on their dividend. So that way you can hold onto their stock even longer, which if you're somebody who's wanting to create that passive income, like we were talking about, that is going to be more likely the companies that you want to be invested in because you have a higher history of knowing that they are paying on their dividends every single quarter or how often they pay. Now, again, that doesn't mean that there is no risk whatsoever, especially when we have downturns in markets. Of course, all stocks typically will be going down during those time periods. So even if you're invested in blue chip stocks that have, you know, not as much risk, that doesn't mean there is no risk whatsoever. So always be paying attention to that aspect of it. But typically, if you are investing in blue chip stocks or companies that have really good histories when it comes to paying out dividends, you're gonna have typically less risk and have less volatility with your money that you put in there initially. Now, really quick, before we continue on, if you are getting some value out of this content so far, do me a favor and hit that like button down below. It really does go a long way for the YouTube algorithms, and I appreciate it. With that being said, let's go ahead and get back onto this list. So the next reason to love dividend investing is because you can reinvest your dividends back into the companies that paid out those dividends. And this is probably one of my favorite things. It is really a great feeling to get paid out dividends and then reinvest those back into the companies to have more ownership. Because the more ownership you have of those companies, the more dividends you're gonna get paid out in the future. So it is really compounding, and the power that it actually will give you is essentially more purchasing power to have more ownership, to have more dividends to get paid out for the future. And it's really great, especially if you are at a younger age where you can really just compound all of those dividends over and over and it really continues to grow. It can mean great payouts in the future, so that way when you are retired or don't wanna work anymore, you can actually have that money coming in from dividends to be able to pay you at a much greater amount than if you just kept those dividends early on. So reinvesting those dividends is a beautiful thing, and it is so great to see the effects of actually putting your money back into the companies that already paid you out those dividends. So next up on this list is going to be for tax benefits. Now, I am no tax expert, so make sure you always get additional information from a tax expert on this information. But when it comes to taxes on your dividends, you're going to be typically taxed quite a bit less than you are with your regular income. So if in the future your goal is to have $2,000 every single month paid out in dividends, you're going to be taxed less on that $2,000 than if you worked for somebody else as a W-2 to actually get taxed on that money. Now, if you work for a company and got paid out that $2,000 on a regular salary, you're gonna get taxed at a much higher rate. So you have some great benefits of having ownership in dividends and getting paid out those and keeping it for yourself versus actually working for somebody else. It is a pretty significant difference, anywhere from 10 to 25% difference in taxes that you will get charged for having dividends as your form of income. And it's a really cool thing, and it's something you wanna really look into and make sure you have all the right information so you can be properly understanding of the tax codes, because of course it's always crazy and wonky all over the place. Now, before we go on to the next one, make sure that you let me know in the comments down below, are you a fan of dividend investing? And if not, what are some of your reasons? I wanna hear from you guys down below, whether you like them or not. I always love having conversations with every single person and what your thoughts are when it comes to dividend investing or growth investing or any options that you have when it comes to putting your money to work harder for you. So the next reason why I absolutely love dividend investing is because of the dividend yield increase. Now, to really break this down, I'm gonna kind of go into a little bit of an example here to make things a little bit easier. But the thing about dividend increases is that this means that you are making more money for doing absolutely nothing. And sometimes this can help you keep up with inflation, because if inflation is going anywhere from 2 to 4%, you wanna make sure that your money is potentially growing with you. Otherwise, you are actually gonna be losing purchasing power over time. So what I mean by this is a lot of companies will actually try to increase their dividend payouts every single year, so that way their dividend yield can stay consistent with where they are with their stock price. Because if a stock price goes crazy high, their dividend yield will actually go down significantly. And what that means is sometimes people don't wanna stay with a stock if their dividend yield is very low. Although alternatively, if the stock plummets, their dividend yield goes really, really high, which is also not a good thing. So keep that stuff in mind. But essentially what dividend yield increasing really does for people is that means that just because you own that stock already and they increase that dividend, that is more purchasing power that you're gonna get in the future, because those dividends are gonna be higher payouts for you, so you can continue to buy more into those stocks like we talked about earlier. So for me, having a dividend yield increase anywhere from 2 to 4% or more just means that my purchasing power for the dividends I'm getting paid out is gonna be continuing to keep up with inflation, which is really important to make sure that your money is worth just as much now as it was before, as well as continuing to grow well past what your potential is for leaving that money in, say, like a bank account or anything else. Now, whether you love dividends or hate dividends, one thing is very true, and this is that if you are investing for your future, whether it is investing in the market, into real estate, you are gonna be doing something that is helping your money grow. You're putting things in assets versus what other people do is put their money in liabilities. So you are definitely taking a step in the right direction, and you can always, of course, change your direction if you feel like there is better options for you as you continue to learn. So for me personally, I think learning about dividends is a fantastic way to get started with investing. It's definitely not the only way, and there are definitely other options that you can potentially earn a lot more money, but of course that typically comes with either more risk or more learning. So definitely keep that in mind when it comes to this list and different options that other people might have. So as I mentioned earlier, I actually do love dividend investing, and I share my journey with you guys here on this channel. So you know, make sure that you check the link in the show notes down below. I'll actually link up some of my more recent videos when it comes to sharing my dividend investing journey, so you guys can kind of get a better understanding of what it takes, what's in my accounts, and how much I'm getting paid out in dividends based off of those numbers, and gives you a better understanding of how dividends work. Now, I mentioned earlier that I have my friend Jared, who also is sharing his thoughts on why maybe dividend investing is not the best option for some people. So I want you to check out his video right over here so you can see some other sides of the coin when it comes to maybe not investing with dividends. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time. And let them know in the comments that you are a dividend fan. Thanks for watching.